Penguin Random House presents Nava Durga by Nalini Ramachandran, read by Rohini Vij. What do you already know about Durga and Navratri? Do you know how many hands Durga has? What are her 9 special forms called? In how many different ways do people celebrate Navratri? If you don't, then listen on. If you do, listen on anyway. You might just discover something you don't already know. Adi Shakti, the diamond in the sky. Hello there. My name is Adi Shakti, and I am a goddess. I don't really have a face or a body, but sometimes I appear as a ball of light. I'm here to tell you my story, and strangely, it begins at a time when everything was dark. A long time before the universe existed, there was complete darkness everywhere. I used to live alone in this darkness then. I wasn't afraid, but I was very lonely and bored. Then I had an idea. I created light from the sun, and suddenly everything was bright. As this light spread near and far, a beautiful universe was formed. But I was still alone in the brightness. So I created new goddesses and gods and gave them different names and superpowers. They came to be known as devas. And they began living in Devalok, the world of gods. One day, I thought the universe should also have ordinary beings, those who weren't gods and didn't have superpowers. So Prithvilok, the world of earthly beings, was created. This is where all of you live. I've heard that Prithvilok is now called Earth by you human beings. I wanted everyone in Prithvilok to be unique. So I began to live invisibly inside each being. Yes, I live inside each one of you, but in the form of shaktis or powers. I'm in your positive thoughts, qualities and habits. I'm your positive energy. I'm your shakti. You just have to find me. While Prithvilok was being created, some gods had given life to mighty beings called asuras. At first, everyone lived together happily. But soon, the asuras felt that they were stronger than the devas. And the devas thought they were more powerful than the asuras. Both groups would fight with each other all the time to gain power over the universe. During such fights, I really missed my dark, lonely life. It used to be so quiet, so peaceful. Because I had started all this by creating the new gods, I felt responsible. And so, I decided to help the devas. I could have helped the asuras too, but some of them were really mean to the devas and to the beings on Prithvilok. Even though I knew the devas weren't good or right all the time, the few nasty asuras made it easy for me to pick a side. So, to help the devas and fight the asuras, I took on a new warrior form called Durga. I made her first appear when... Hey, wait a minute. Maybe Durga should tell you her story herself? Durga, the warrior goddess, says hello. Whoops! Hello? I was just practicing some fight moves. I'm Durga. Adi Shakti's warrior form. As a warrior goddess, I'm always ready for a war. Why, you ask? Well, because the Asuras keep scaring the Devas, shoo them out of their own homes in Devalok, steal their stuff. Oof, the list just goes on. So my main job is to protect the Devas and Prithvi Lok too by fighting the Asuras and other evil beings. No, I don't fight all the time. I'm a lot like you, actually. I laugh and cry. I talk and sleep. I eat and drink. And I have secrets to keep. But I'm also unlike human beings. I have 10 hands and 3 eyes. Yes, I have a third eye on my forehead. Another cool thing about me is that I can live forever. I can be reborn again and again, or create a new me and have a new name and story in every life or form. Like the Nava Durga, my 9 special forms. And oh, I can live alongside another avatar of mine. For example, I can see and talk to Ambika, who is one of my many forms. It's a little strange, but it's fun too. That reminds me, I have the most fun during Navratri, the festival where human beings worship my 9 special forms every year during September and October. I enjoy coming to your homes, eating tasty foods, getting dressed in all the shiny clothes you gift me, singing and dancing with you, and fulfilling your wishes too. There's so much I want to tell you about. All those interesting Navratri celebrations, how I and the Navadurga came into being, and also about how I live inside you as Shaktis or powers that each of the Navadurga is known for. But I feel I will just confuse you with all those different names and forms I have. Why don't you go ahead and listen to these tales while I go and practice some moves with my Trishul? The story of Durga, the protector of good and the destroyer of evil. The Asuras had not always been mean, but some of them desired to possess the same kind of superpowers that the Devas had. So they would often pray to the 3 powerful gods, Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva, and ask for clever boons. In Hindu mythology, Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva are known as Tridev, the 3 chief gods. Brahma is the creator of Prithvilok. Vishnu protects the universe and Shiva destroys evil. These gods granted them such powers because they could not say no to someone who had prayed to them sincerely. Once they got such powers and boons, the Asuras would use their new powers to trouble the Devas and even throw them out of their homes in Devalok. Over time, these Asuras became very cruel. So much so, that instead of being known as mighty beings, the Asuras came to be called demons. Durgam was one such Asura. He wanted to be the king of all 3 worlds, Devalok, Prithvilok and Patalalok, the world where the Asuras live. So he prayed to Brahma.
"I am pleased with your prayers," said Brahma, as he appeared in front of Durgam. "What do you wish for?"
Durgam was a smart Asura, and he knew exactly what to ask for.
"I want to be 100 times stronger than the Devas. Also, I want all 4 Vedas," he said.
"Granted,"
Brahma declared.
Durgam was thrilled. He had asked for the 4 Vedas.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.